Hey guys, so first of all, you may be wondering, Katie, why are you whispering? Well, that's because I've been watching a lot of ASMR content recently and I just really felt like making some of my own. And I thought I would do an ASMR version of showing you my manga collection. And obviously, as this is my first ASMR. And stuff. It's kind of a take off Fruits Basket, to be honest, but Also, my foot is on a cushion right now, so if you can hear that, yeah, this will always be my favourite manga ever. I can read it again and again, and I just love it so much. I actually cosplayed Yuki, like years ago. Very badly, to be honest, but you know. So yes, Vampire Night is about a girl called Yuki Cross, who is at Cross Academy, an academy for humans and vampires who are respectively, and kind of Yuki's been adopted by the headmaster because her parents obviously, well, she has lost all her memories, so we don't know what's happened to her. But yeah, and then also the headmaster's other adopted son called Zero, and they're like the guardians of the school, so they've got to kind of like protect the day class from finding out that the night class are vampires. So this is going, a lot of stuff happens. I would highly recommend you read the manga, whether the awesome than what you need anime, to be honest. The manga will obviously always go further than the anime, but don't judge it just by the fact it has vampires. It's not my Twilight, it's not trash, I promise you that. I think it's great, and yeah, as cheesy as this sounds, Vampire Night will always have like always have a very special place in my heart. So yeah, that is Vampire Night, because we're gonna go to Monyona, Sailor Moon. Yeah, this doesn't really need that much explaining, but yeah, we've got Sailor Moon. I think I have every volume of this year. The cover's very pretty, to be honest, so one I got, deserve. No, like, it's just pretty cute. I'm happy if you are wanting something like that. And next, we're gonna go to this big boy. I got a big boy manga. This is a heavy one. This is Twinkle Stars. I own three. I think there might be a fourth one out. I can't remember, but it's another romance. Surprise, surprise. You can tell I really like. Oh, God. another like romance high school one, but it's just so funny. It's about this girl here, Chihiro Sakura. She falls in love with this guy who's like a manga artist, and like, and he just like doesn't ever notice. It's so funny. And again, the OP is like 10 out of 10, so I really recommend this one. Yu's always adored shoujo manga and yearns for the day when someone might give her that kind of attention and a love convention. disappointed and confused when you enter high school. When she sees a confident and beautiful student council member, Nanami, when the next person to confess to you is Nanami herself, is her romantic dream finally true? So yeah, it's just a cute little romance story. Actually being adapted into an anime for next year, so I'm very excited. I've already just got my hands on this, so I'm keen to get the rest in the series. Basically, corporate sex secretary Shiratani suffers from OCD. One day he meets Kuros, a therapist who offers to take him through the 10-step program to supposedly cure him. So, as the two get to know each other through the steps, Shiratani's attraction to his counselor grows. So it's kind of obvious where it goes there. Not gonna lie, the number one is a bit, the cover is slightly misleading. The manga writer actually wrote that in it herself. So number one doesn't really have much going in terms of, you know, sexy stuff, as you could say. But number two certainly picks up the pace. Again, as I say, so just keep that in mind, and I really like the artwork as well.